First of all, on behalf of Central Executive Committee of Student Federation of India, revolutionary greetings to all delegates, comrades. CITU and SFI, both the organizations formed in the same year, 1970. And that 1970, there was so many protests across the world. There was the protest start from Kent State University, USA, against Vietnam War, and across Europe, in so many countries, there was protest against the government, against the policies. And that time, there was a conflict in between that students, that protesting students. Somebody said, this movement is only students' movement. We don't want to allow any workers or peasants in this movement. And another part, the other students, they said, we have to include them also. But it was become a students' protest only, students' fight only, and there was no such political change happened. In 1974, SFI's second All India Conference in Kolkata, that was inaugurated by Comrade P. Sundaraiah. In that inaugural speech, Comrade P. Sundaraiah said, the students, their concern is not only educational issues. The issues which directly affecting students, that is like increasing of fee hike and decreasing of seat cut, this issue. But also, their issue is relating to their parents. Their parents is workers and peasants. What they are directly affecting their parents, that also considered by students. And they have to fight for them also. They have to fight together with their parents and for their rights also. So in our country, that's why last January 8th, General Strike, SFI also gave a call to join with the workers. But I'm thinking the almost our country, I think more than 30 crore, that much workers take part in that movement. Peasants also take part, students and youth, everybody take part in that. But how much that issues discussing in our country, that's the main question. About unemployment, about other issues which raised in that joint struggle. And students, there have so many issues we are raising. Youth also, so many issues facing. Women also facing so many issues. Workers, agriculture workers, peasants facing so many issues. But that is not in limelight. Earlier in everywhere, not only in India, in USA, last election, president election time, that Trump said, what is the problem behind the unemployment in our country, that is US? That is because of outsourcing and migration. That is the same thing they are doing in our country also. Everywhere, if there is any question against the right-wing politics, if there is any question against the corporates, then they will say that there is some enemy with the poorest, more than poor people than you. They are the reason for your unemployment. They are the reason for your poor condition. They are the reason for your all the problems. The same thing they used in Gujarat riot time. They said to Dalits, the minority Muslims are the problem for your unemployment and your poverty and your all problems. And same thing through CIA that is happening in our country. That's why we are fighting against CIA. The country in which the country, they are asking for the our ancestors' records. Where? Here, our Prime Minister, he failed to find out his degree certificates. Where the country here, in every year, consecutively, so many cyclone and other floods are happening in our country, and because of that, so many people, they are losing their households. And so many working class people don't have house and land in our country. Then that people, to that people, The government is asking for their ancestors' documents of, about land. How many people have land till now? And what about the situation in before 1971? So students are also fighting against this because we know the importance of public education. Most of the students who are studying in these colleges, they are like the struggle started from Jamia, AMU and JNU across the country, everywhere this protest is going on. And most of the students who are studying in these central universities, they are the first generation getting education, and they are the first generation from their family to have the opportunity to get higher education. And we know the importance of public education. We are strengthening through the public education. The example is Kerala. So we need public education. For public education, democratic country, secularism, that is needed. Our constitution should be continued. Then only the public education will be stronger. Then only we can live in this country. So for safeguarding our constitution, for safeguarding our secularism, for safeguarding our country, the student workers and peasants have jointly together hand, and we have to fight against this RSS regime, Narendra Modi government. This word, I am concluding. Inqilab Zindabad, workers, student unity, long live.